All right, we got the die roll. Avoided having the same opponent, so hopefully this will go a little faster. And, yeah. Choosing to play is same as always. Still going to make a 3 drop, not going to make a 1 or a 2. Opponent very likely will make a 2. And let's see what it is. He gets Rotting Rats. Okay, so I'm not making a 3. So basically that lets him trade his, he just traded his 3 for my 3 and got a 1-1 out of the deal. That's probably right around fair. Okay. Very vanilla 3-3 trample. Oh no. This guy eventually goes nuts. So I need to kill him quickly. Alright, let's make sure I'm actually making a creature. And not, like, whiffing. Because there are some whiffs even at 5. Okay, so I can attack with the elephant. And certainly will. And Martin Strongald. It basically means that at some point he gets to hit me with a really, really big Alpha Strike. No, that guy blocks both of my guys. I need an attacker before I get run over. Earthshaker. That's not an attacker. Not really. Oh, dang. I F6, so I couldn't auto-yield. Oh, well. I'll auto-yield next time. I guess I'll auto-yield the first time I'm not F6ing on his turn. Okay. Well, I'll hit with Earthshaker. Man. 8-8. Trample. Good. I'm definitely going to make a 6 here rather than a 7. No, actually, there's an extra 7 that kills Martin Stromgold because it pyroclasms. So I'm actually going to make a 7. And that didn't work so well. I mean, I'm willing to trade the 4-5 for a 4-4 right now, obviously. Yeah, give me that all day long. When he's got the Martin Stromgald, anything I can do to lower his creature count is fantastic by me. I'm not going to graft on his creature. No, no thank you. So, if he attacks with his Woodcrasher, yeah. I'm perfectly happy to trade my guy here. Again, I'm only trading down a little bit, and it slows down Martin Stromgald, so... it's worth it to me. Plus, if I don't block that guy, it's just going to kill me in a couple of turns. Because he'll attack with it and Martin Stromgald after playing a land. And it'll be like 15-15. Okay, Towering Baleth, not bad. Can't attack, unfortunately. And this is attacking or blocking creature with flying. Okay. He doesn't have a forest anyway. Okay, Slipstream Serpent, which I will happily attack my Towering Baleth into. Come on, something good. No, that's not anything good. But whatever, continue to trade slightly down. That's funny. And maybe I'll make another Tunneler Worm. Three of the same 8-drop in a row? That would be insane. I've never actually seen that happen. Alright, Tunneler Worm. Go. Alright, he made a Trampler guy. Deep spawn. Oh man, there's a Champions qualifier on right now? Ooh. No, I'm dedicated. I'm here for you. I'm here for you. So pretty soon he's gonna have to pull the trigger on Martin Stromgald to avoid me. Oh well, not if he gets the nuts. That guy will kill my Tombstalker, and then he can just make a random 2-dropped for his Stromgald. Yes, I would like to put 2 cards from my library into my graveyard. What is his ability? He taps? Yeah, he gets tapped and gains Shroud. Useful stuff. Man, if I had gotten this guy, it would have been insane. Whoa, we got a Lorthos. So I could attack with Deep Spawn here, but does that get me ranched by Martin Stromgald? I think if I'm getting ranched by Stromgald, I'm getting ranched by it regardless. I'm just gonna attack. I should have attacked first. Alright, so he's just trading, thank goodness. With this board, anything that involves his guys trading for my guys is fine. Okay, so he's just gonna clear all the, guys. Which is not surprising. I mean, that leaves him at an advantage. I still need to find an answer to the Scourge of Courages. And it blocks my Tombstalker in the meantime, too. Alright, I need to get some hits here. I need Pro Red, or okay, sure. At least it makes him use Scourge for another turn, and I get a card. It's kind of sweet looking, too. Oh, man. Is he just going to make an 8? He's just making an 8. What a beast. Yeah, I have to make an 8 and not a 9 here, unfortunately. Because I need an answer to Scourge, and the ones at 9 are not good. Especially when I only have 4 mountains. Because there's a guy that deals damage equal to the number of mountains you have. Nice! That doesn't get stopped by his Scourge. And because I've had Baleful Force for 2 turns, I'm gonna actually have enough mana for to utilize this guy. Sweet. Now he's gotta hit a good 8. See, now this is a fun new card to hit. Because most of the time, you're not going to have the extra lands. So then you've got to make the decision of whether you're going to hold on to it or get rid of it. Can he try and race me here? I don't think that works. Like, it would work if I attacked with only Colossus. That's definitely not my plan. Yeah, now he's just dead. He needed to keep back all 3 blockers to not die. But I think this was still his best shot. It has trample, right? Yeah. 20-20 trample. And then I just attack with everything and he dies. Assuming I don't mess up my trample damage. Baleful Force Colossus of Akros combo. Yeah, this is exciting to hit at 8. I hadn't even thought of this guy, and he's very interesting in Momir. Yeah. My opponent did the math.